Okay, now this is a bit of a cluster. I mean, Kevin Feige was all set. He had an elegant solution, which I had recommended, because it was so obvious in its beautiful simplicity. And that's just to move every movie back by one release date, which is exactly what he did. But oh, Sony. Amy Pascal. This is such a bad situation. All right, so the biggest casualty by far, and the big headline, is a huge delay for Doctor Strange 2. I mean, we were willing to wait a little bit. We were real nice about it. But this is ridiculous. This is basically the next Avengers movie like Captain America Civil War was. I told you Shang-Chi is going to have some fighters in there, but considering they're trying to make it so authentic to the region, to China, as many of you have speculated, it's probably going to be other Marvel Chinese and Asian characters from, again, that area, martial arts characters, right? So, you know, Doctor Strange in the multiverse, the multiverse of madness, with Avengers showing up, maybe some who are dead, that's a big freaking deal. Now, that was originally slated to kick off summer 2021, as it should have. That's a summer movie. But then, because of coronavirus, and we were all cool with it, it moved to the holiday season 2021. Okay, that's cool. Holiday movies are a big deal. We'll take it. But now, it's leapfrogged over Thor Love and Thunder itself, moving up a week so that it could open for Valentine's Day, although that's a no-brainer. Like, I'm glad they did that and reserved the date. I mean, it's called Thor Love and Thunder. There's a Valentine's Day movie. Why would you come out like 4 days after Valentine's Day? Stupid. All right, so anyway, now Doctor Strange 2 is set for March 25th, 2022. Making it basically 2 years away. Oh my God, Wanda stands, start crying now. You've probably already started crying. And that leads me to the next obvious question. What does this do to WandaVision? Oh my God. Marvel has been saying it will still hit Disney Plus by the end of this year. But will it? I mean, that would make it like over a year until we got to see the repercussions in Doctor Strange 2. That series is supposed to lead directly into Doctor Strange 2. It's supposed to be a slingshot effect. It gets people to subscribe and go and watch Disney Plus, but then they all go when they go and see the movie. It gets everyone all excited, right? But, you know, there are extended production delays. They had a wrap party. They had an early wrap party on WandaVision, but they still had some shooting to go. Falcon and Winter Soldier hasn't finished its shooting. They apparently, Sebastian Stan recently said it was not just a few days. They have a good chunk of shooting to go. So nobody, it's Hollywood speculating, by the way, that no one's going to start filming until 2021. So, oh my God. All right. And then you have post-production has also been slowed down. So even if these were completed, it might slow when they're ready. And then, of course, there's again the creative angle. I mean, are you really going to debut WandaVision over a year before the movie that it leads into comes out? That seems not good. So I think this probably means there's a WandaVision delay. I hope not. I hope not. But if they haven't even finished filming it, there has to be. They can't, again, 2021 to start filming. All right, so also, speaking of production, Spider-Man 3 didn't even start. It was supposed to start in July, but that ain't happening. So now they have to have a new date. So Feige gave them Doctor Strange 2's date in November, the new one. That's too nice, in my opinion. I'd be like, look, Sony, just be happy you're part of the team. You take the March 25th date, quite frankly. I mean, a number of you were like, oh, and by the way, Spider-Man 3 was always supposed to come after Doctor Strange 2, so it's not like there's a story element that's going to get messed up here. So I'd be like, see ya, you swing into 2022. And a lot of you are saying Spider-Man's always been a summer movie. Great, March is kind of summery, take it. But by the way, since it's now a November movie, I tweak that script and put a Christmas element in there. I mean, home has to be in the title. That's the big theme for this trilogy. And everyone's saying, you know, even John Watts has said he's influenced by John Hughes, which means, I mean, John Hughes is like Mr. Christmas in many ways. So I think that seems like a no-brainer. I'd be working on those changes right now. They got time. They got now time, unfortunately. Now, as for Doctor Strange 2, which did take that stupid March date, Although I guess, you know, Sam Raimi, this better be phenomenal considering how much prep time you have. But March is not like that. March isn't like a bad date. I mean, Captain Marvel and Beauty and the Beast, in my notes it looked like Batman, but Beauty and the Beast, they both opened in March and they both joined the Billion Dollar Club. So it's a fine date. It's a fine date. It's not a great date though. It's like the worst date that Doctor Strange has had. Now, thankfully, Thor Love and Thunder, which was supposed to come after Doctor Strange 2, they haven't started shooting yet either. So Taika Waititi can tweak that script. So, I mean, I'm sure they're not that related, but if there were any continuity problems, they can be easily ironed out. But let's take a look at 2022 now for Marvel. It's ridiculous. All right, so Thor Love and Thunder and Doctor Strange 2 are just about a month apart. What? Then Doctor Strange 2 is much bigger in scope than Black Panther 2. It has to be, or what's the point of doing a multiverse story? And no disrespect to Black Panther 2. I'm excited about all these movies. But Black Panther 2 is the big summer movie instead of Doctor Strange 2? I mean, it maybe seems like maybe those two should switch, right? And they're also about only a month apart as well. I mean, these are just too close together. It's too close. And then Captain Marvel 2 is July 8th, 2022. And then remember that valuable October 7th, 2022 date? Spider-Verse just got it. And with all due respect to Spider-Verse, I love the first Spider-Verse movie, even though hardly anybody went to see it. But it won an Oscar. That's good, right? And I'm very happy they're continuing the story. But considering the pedigree of that date, it should have been Blade. And it's not Blade, it's Spider-Verse, which I think is just a waste of that date, quite frankly. As for 2021, that's now Eternals, Shang-Chi, Venom 2, and Spider-Man 3. I don't think that's very well balanced in 2022, to be honest with you. I mean, we've been waiting and waiting for the next Marvel phase to get started, and it seems like it's going to get off to a real slow start. Those movies better frickin' deliver. I mean, wow. From a business perspective and a fan perspective. I mean, they can't deliver from a business perspective if they don't deliver from a fan perspective. So, what do you think about this? I mean, we'll take it and we'll like it. What else are we gonna do? But I do think that Doctor Strange 2 should have stayed on its date, and they should have stuck Spider-Man in the March date, 2022. What do you think? Share your thoughts down below, subscribe today, and of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.